Hello everyone, welcome back to the chapter 12 of hematology, that is coagulation of blood. Consider subscribing to my channel for more of such handwritten medical lectures and don't forget to hit the notification bell. Coagulation of blood. Coagulation or clotting is the process in which blood loses the fluidity and becomes a jelly-like mass. So basically coagulation is nothing but clotting. Clot is a mesh of thin fibrils entangling the blood cells. Now here the fibrils consist of fibrin, which is formed by fibrinogen. Now coagulation of blood occurs through series of reactions due to activation of a group of factors. As you can see, there are 13 factors: factor 1, fibrinogen; factor 2, prothrombin; factor 3, thromboplastin; factor 4, calcium; factor 5, labile factor; factor 6, presence is not proved yet; factor 7, stable factor; factor 8, antihemophilic factor; factor 9, Christmas factor; and factor 10, Stewart-Prower factor. Factor 11 is the plasma thromboplastin antecedent; factor 11, Hegma factor; factor 13, fibrin stabilizing factor. Sequence of clotting mechanism. Now most of the clotting factors are proteins in the form of enzymes. So basically what all these factors which I mentioned earlier, these are inactive proenzymes which are activated. So there is proenzyme-enzyme conversions. There are three stages, to be very specific, through which the clotting mechanism or the coagulation cascade happens. Now here in this, I have made a chart or a flow chart which will be easy to understand the stages. In stage 1, there are two pathways, intrinsic and extrinsic, which will lead to the formation of prothrombin activator. Stage 2 is all about prothrombin conversion to thrombin, and stage 3 is about activation of the fibrinogen. In the first stage, intrinsic pathway, whenever there is injury, endothelium damage occurs and collagen is exposed. This collagen exposure causes factor 12 activation, which in turn activates the factor 11, and which again in turn activates the factor 9, which again the activated factor 9 activates the factor 10. It is kind of they activate each other one by one, which will later lead through the activation of the prothrombin. When platelets come in contact with collagen, it releases phospholipids, which later activate the prothrombin. In extrinsic pathway, whenever there is tissue damage, tissue thromboplastin is released, which contains glycoproteins and phospholipids, which activates the factor 10 in presence of calcium ion, factor 5 and thrombin. So basically in stage 1 there is formation of prothrombin activator. Now we come to the stage 2, that is formation of thrombin. The prothrombin is converted into thrombin by prothrombin activator in presence of calcium. Stage 3, thrombin converts fibrinogen into activated fibrinogen. The fibrin polymerizes and forms loosely arranged strands of fibrins, which later forms the tight blood clot. Thank you for watching the video and do subscribe.